Day number six, March 18th, 2017. And the time is 9:17 a.m. I slept in a little bit. You know, the body is a little bit tired from the week that I just had. And, you know, this is my only morning that I can kind of, you know, sleep in for a little bit. So I took full advantage of it. Woke up, energy's high, about to step on the scale for another day. And we're at 179.2, so I'm still dropping weight little by little. Like I said, everything's starting to really lean out. Abs are coming real nice. I'm starting to see a lot of definition. So day six is here. Got one session at 10:30, another session at 12, and then I'll finally hit the gym in a little bit. So looking forward to day six. I just finished my first session of the day here on Saturday, teaching a self-defense class, and on my way to session two in a bit. It's Saturday. The grind does not stop. There's no stopping with me. I'm on a mission to help as many people as I can. But I've just been thinking a lot lately, you know, where I was 4 or 5 months ago living in Cleveland. I was unhappy, I was unmotivated, I was falling into some bad habits, bad ruts, and I was falling into the old person that I was, who I was trying to break away from. And I thought being back home, you know, I changed a little bit, but obviously I didn't. And so, you know, having the opportunity to go all in and pursue what I want to do with the rest of my life is what I did. And here I am 4 months later, living in Florida. It's beautiful down here. I can't complain. But I wake up every single morning and I look at my schedule and all the people that I get to help. And it is truly so rewarding. And that's the life I wanted to live on my own terms, is I wanted to create my own schedule, my own freedom. I wanted to do what I want to do, but I wanted to do it on my own terms. And helping people as much as I can is what I want to do. So if I'm working 7 days a week, I'm not complaining about that. I made the schedule. And so there's a lot of people out there that have, you know, they fall into these bad habits, they fall into these ruts, and they can't get out of it. You have to make yourself uncomfortable. If you're comfortable working for that 9-to-5 job, you're working for your boss's dreams, your company's dreams, like if you're not happy, then you gotta find a way to realize what you're good at, what you're great at, and you need to put all your eggs in one basket, and you need to pursue that. And so there's a lot of times where people, they just, you know, they're scared to take the risks, they're scared to fail, they're scared of what someone else thinks. I was like that. I could not tell you how many times I was worried about, you know, how many likes my Instagram pic is going to get, or how many Facebook likes I'm going to get. You know what? I completely changed my way of thinking, and it has completely changed to where I don't really care about what other people may think of me. I know the path that I'm on. I know the mission that is ahead of me, and I believe that I'm doing the right thing, and I'm trying to help out as many people as I can with the gifts and the talents that, you know, I've been given through the man above. So, you know, that's just my message for people today is know what you're good at, know what you're great at, and go get it. Just got to Naples Family Fitness, about to put this work in, and kill this workout. So I'll talk to you guys soon.
I wrote the song as a message for help on behalf of anybody finding themselves. I wrote this letter to numb your pain, 'cause every day I wake up I'm feeling the same. I got issues just like you got issues. I've been hurt, I've seen the scar tissue. If I showed you, would you run away? Do I gotta hide them for you to wanna stay? Do I even need you? Should I leave you? Do I gotta be you just to please you? Do I say I'm all good when I bleed you through my heart? Quit tearing mine apart.
it going. Gotta keep. 4:30 in the afternoon, and just killed that workout at Naples Family Fitness. Great shoulders, biceps, abs workout. Feel good day number 6. Got my 50 grams of protein. I got my oatmeal. I got my eggs and bacon. I got my avocado. There's a couple over there making out. I'm good to go. Life is good. So I'm on my way to get my grocery shopping done for the week. And then I will stop and grab an earned meal. Looking forward to that. So I am doing really, really well today. Feel great. Body feels tight. Energy feels high. And day 6 is rolling. So as I've said before, life is about balance, and you should reward yourself for hard work. I was very strict with myself Monday through Friday. I was within the guidelines of my 8 hours that I was eating, and when I was in that feeding window, I was eating healthy. So I definitely believe in rewarding yourself, and this is just what I like to do on the weekends, usually Saturday night and Sunday night. I'll probably have another one tomorrow, but I like to reward myself for my hard work, and I don't believe in going long periods of time and being strict within your diet. I like to enjoy myself. So here we have a couple donuts, which is always a favorite of mine, a burger, fries, and a milkshake. So I'm definitely going to enjoy this. And we're about 6:36 p.m. So I'll probably have some of this now and a little bit later, and that will be my food for the day. So I'm gonna enjoy this right now. So I'll talk to you guys later. So I have some good news and I have some bad news. The good news is all the food is gone. The burger's gone, the fries are gone, the milkshake's gone, even the donuts. Got about a half of one left, so I will save that for tomorrow. The bad news is I don't feel too good. So I think I overdid it tonight, but like I said, every once in a while, you deserve to reward yourself with something not technically healthy. And that is just what I did, but just don't overdo it like I did. So, you know, body feels all right. Still, focus is very high. Energy is very high. I'm very curious as to what I'll be, you know, weight-wise when I wake up in the morning, how my body's going to feel. I teach a 9 a.m. boxing class, so that should be interesting to see how my energy is going to feel tomorrow for that class. But overall, you know, the lesson is if you're putting in the work in the gym, and you're making changes for the better in your diet, you deserve to reward yourself every now and then. I'm not the type of trainer that gives my my clients a calorie deficit diet. You don't need to be in a calorie deficit to get abs. That's just it's bad information. And if you want to get abs, you want to be toned, you just gotta start eating better. A lot of times you think you're eating less, and that's what's going to happen. But actually, if you actually eat more of better things, it's going to boost up your metabolism. And then once your metabolism kind of gets firing, then you can start playing around with your meals and your calories and all that stuff once you start to plateau. But I mean, for some people that takes a couple months, and so just going right into 1,000 calories a day or 1,200 calories a day, that's garbage, it's nonsense. And it's something that I've never used with any of my people that I've worked with. And it's something I've never used with myself. I've never been a calorie counter. I don't pay much attention to the macros because, like I said, your body is going to change every single day because you're going to be doing different things. That's just how it works. So I don't pay much attention to it. I know it's important, but I just don't pay much attention to it. And like I said, I've been doing this for years, and I've never had an issue. I've never, I've played around with my fitness pal and stuff like that, but at the end of the day, you don't need that. It's extracurricular, it's just a tool. But I'm all about balance. Put the work in the gym, put the work in the kitchen, and if you're consistent and you're honest with yourself, please reward yourself. Go out, have that drink,
have that unhealthy meal, like go out, be social. So that's my lesson to you, and I'll talk to you guys soon.